If you are someone who uses AI regularly, especially ChatGPT, you realize that AI uses M dashes so much that nowadays, some of us conclude whether a writing is AI generated or not just by spotting the M dashes. So what the heck are M dashes and why do AI use them so much? Watch out so that you won't be mistaken into using AI when you did not. So, for a start, what are M dashes? You see, in the English language, there are three types of dashes: the hyphen, the N dash, and the M dash. Hyphen is the shortest, N dash is like the length of the letter N, so it's longer than hyphen, and M dash is like the length of the letter M, so it's the longest. The hyphen is something we use very regularly. It's to connect words to create a new word, like part-time, full-time, son-in-law, and whatnot. The second, called the N dash, is used usually to express a range, like for example, Monday to Friday, $1 to $100 and whatnot lah. So you can say that it's kind of true or true if you were to read it out. It can also be used for a relationship, like mother something. Now, what the heck are M dashes then? Okay, this is the more versatile one, as it can be used for many purposes. You see, you can use it like a comma, a semicolon, a colon, or a bracket. But it's just that using it kind of made those punctuation points kind of more impactful. For example, if I were to use it as a comma, the comma version would have looked like this. But if I use M dash instead, it will be like this. You see, it makes the comma stronger. And it's the same for all the punctuation marks that they can replace. For example, if I want to use brackets, a sentence could have been like this. And if I were to replace brackets with M dashes, it will be like this. You can see how much more impactful the punctuation mark has become, even when the words didn't change. It's because M dash is associated with a drastic change. It's like a long and strong pause, and yet the timing and words do not change. This is why M dashes can be used to set a new direction in a sentence, like this. Cause you can see here that initially, the direction is a positive association of the blue cat, and after the M dash, it becomes negative. Oh, go bilang! But you get the idea. Also, whether there's a space before and after the M dash depends on the style you are using. There are more that you can know about it, so I have left a link or more details about it in the description. So, what the heck happened recently? You see, if you use AI regularly, you'll realize that recently, AI, especially ChatGPT, has been using M dashes in their writing so much that if you didn't see an M dash in the response, you might wonder if it's a real person replying to you. It got so bad that if we were using AI to tidy our writing, we would have to remove the M dash so it won't look so obvious that we are using AI. This kind of went viral after a podcast by two Gen Z kinyas spoke about the phenomenon and called it a ChatGPT hyphen. A clip of them saying that went viral after someone shared it online, shocked that Gen Z kinyas were calling an M dash the ChatGPT hyphen. You see, it's bad because M dash is a legit useful punctuation mark. So, with AI using it so often, people just either consciously or subconsciously conclude that a piece of writing is AI generated, should we have M dashes. But why? There is a hyphen key on your keyboard, but here's the thing. Regardless of what keyboard you use, there is no N dash or M dash on your keyboard. You have to kind of press a code to type out an M dash. If you are using Windows, you have to hold the alternate key, then press O, then 1, then 5, then 1. If you are using Mac, you have to hold Option and Shift, then press hyphen. Some programs, like Microsoft Word, allow you to create M dash by typing two hyphens between two letters. Therefore, here's the thing, it's almost unnatural to use it that much due to the difficulty of using it, and so, people don't usually use it. Hence, if you use it nowadays, people might think you are using AI instead, even if you didn't use AI. Which leads to the question, why are AI suddenly using it? Well, the question should be, why does one AI suddenly become so obsessed with it? Got a wedding coming up or want to surprise someone with a one-of-a-kind gift? The Blue Cats do private custom videos too. Yes, even for an annoying brother's birthday. Click the link in our description to find out more. Firstly, it likely started just recently, around late last year. I know because I have been using AI for very long and only discovered this phenomenon recently. According to knowyourmeme.com, it likely started from October 2024 when people from Reddit started to discuss about it. But why? Well, it turns out that it's mainly due to the ChatGPT LLM. You see, a recent experiment compared outputs from a few AI systems and was given the same prompt. OpenAI's ChatGPT produced a 573-word article containing 8 M dashes. And a similar pattern was seen in Microsoft GPT-based Copilot. DeepSeek, which is originally a GPT as well, used 9 M dashes in about 550 words. Conversely, models like Google's Gemini and Meta's Llama used 0 M dashes in their responses of similar length, while Claude was somehow in between, although I personally think it doesn't use that many M dashes. So, what the heck is going on with ChatGPT? Well, you see, for a start, it's not just ChatGPT that uses a lot of M dashes. Is that we humans tend to use very few, but I speculated that as ChatGPT trains more, it realized that M dash is useful since it serves a lot of functions. After all, it's used quite frequently in informal writing. And unlike us, it doesn't think that it's unnatural since it doesn't use a keyboard to type. And so, ta-da! It started to use more as it realized that it's useful, kind of like a kid who first tasted chocolate and has loved chocolate since then. Therefore, it's not that ChatGPT uses it a lot, it's that we don't use it, and when there's such a stark difference, it becomes more pronounced. It's also more obvious nowadays, as we are all using more AI to generate text meant to send to others, leading to more people noticing this telltale sign. This explains why newer models haven't picked up this habit, and given time, they might also follow the same style. Of course, how it will evolve and further change will depend on how it will be trained. But one thing is for sure, AI can never duplicate Singlish perfectly because they didn't know about one single hidden trick about Singlish. Watch this to know what really makes Singlish Singlish based on this single hidden trick. And thank you for spending almost 6 minutes with me. I really appreciate it and hope that you learned something.